So today let's take a look at this Chinese brick game from eBay, which is actually something completely different than it seems. It looks like the classic brick game where basically those bricks are falling on the display and you have to arrange them such a way that you make a complete row and this row disappears, and if you fill the entire screen with the bricks, the game is over. But this one does something else. And I have bought it on eBay a long time ago, but I didn't have time to make a video about it. So let's make the video now. So it basically looks like it has some speaker, some screws, some battery cover, the display, some buttons, and there is also some LED on it. And when you press some buttons, it activates the LED. This one doesn't do anything, and when you press the other buttons, bloody hell! It gives you electric shock! This is actually not a real brick game. The LCD display is completely fake and it's meant as a prank, and you give it to somebody and he gets an electric shock. I'm not really sure about the safety of this. It's probably fine in China, but I'm not sure if this is legal or not in some other countries. I'm not an expert on legality of this and if this is up to safety standards of rich countries like America, Canada, European Union, UK, Australia and so on. And there are basically some buttons and this one activates the LED and the other ones are connected to something that gives you shocks. And it seems like this battery cover is actually not a battery cover. You can't even remove it and it's kind of metalized. This is probably too cheap for this to be real metal, but it's kind of metal-plated plastic. And those buttons as well, they are some chrome-plated plastic or something and they work as electrodes, basically. This is one electrode and those are the other, because the current basically has to go in a circle, so you have to have two electrodes to give a shock. Unless you rely on a capacitive current, of course. But of course this is a small object with almost no capacitance and it's not connected to ground, so it can't rely on a capacitive current. And so basically when you press any of those buttons, bloody hell, it gives you a shock. And there is an on-off button, which the user is probably going to press first and it gives shocks. Can I measure the current? Let's set my multimeter to milliamps AC and let's connect one probe with this electrode and the other one with some button and let's press it. 3.5 milliamps. But it's probably not that much when it goes via the resistance of a human body. So let's put myself in series and it shows 0.12 milliamps. That's not too much, but of course if your fingers are wet, it's going to be more current. And now it is 0.3 milliamps. And of course here's my cat, which is curious what's happening here. And it's from eBay for about $2.20, including shipping, and here you can see some keywords and now I realized how fast the time flies. I have bought it 2 years ago and now I'm getting to make a video about it. But of course they still sell a lot of those dodgy products which give you electric shocks. There is like 10, 15, 20 different versions. I think I have already reviewed about 10 or 15 or more different versions of those electric shock toys. And my cat thinks I'm crazy. And of course now let's try to open it, without giving any electric shocks to my cat, of course. But she's very curious. She always wonders what's happening on my bench, which is actually not a bench, but just a cardboard. And here you can see the internals. Here are the plastic buttons with some chrome plating on it, which is conductive, and the screws and the two buttons, some transformer, some contacts, the batteries, the LED. So let's take a closer look at it. Here's the LED, a white one, 3 button cells, so it's probably 4.5 volts. Those two buttons, this one is for the LED and this one is for the shock. And it has some kind of wire or spring on it to make contact with those metalized buttons, basically. So you can get the shock. And this contact goes to the fake battery cover, which is of course not a battery cover, because those are the batteries. And here's the power supply or inverter. It's some kind of high voltage generator or inverter, which contains a chip, which is just under a blob of something, and the transformer. And the chip basically switches the coil, because you need AC to transform voltages, and the batteries are DC. Well, it broke now. So let's try to draw a schematic of it. And here's the schematic of it, which is quite simple. Here's the battery, the LED, which has this button, and it doesn't even have any resistor. The current is limited basically by just the resistance of this battery. And the other button goes into this chip, which is basically just chip on a board under a blob. And it has three terminals, basically the positive, negative, and the output, which switches and it goes into this transformer. It's a step-up transformer. It basically switches the voltage into this part of it with less turns on it, and then on this section of it with more turns, a much higher voltage appears. One end of the windings goes into those metalized buttons, and the other end of it goes into this fake battery cover. And of course my cat is curious. She has to study the schematic. And the fake display is just basically some kind of board. Is it plastic? It's just a piece of plastic. And it has this protective layer on it. That's interesting. And here's the transformer on a freight core with three terminals. It's basically like an auto transformer. And the chip on a board. You don't really see much. I've put it back together and let's do some measurements in it. And now let's try to see it on my oscilloscope. The upper trace is the battery voltage, which seems to drop under the load of it. And the lower trace is the voltage on the primary, which has short pulses here. And it's of course quite a crappy design. It basically switches about 50% duty cycle, but the primary has a very low resistance, so a lot of voltage basically drops on the resistance of the battery, and despite switching 50% duty cycle, the output pulses are very short. It basically generates the high voltage just when the chip turns off. When it turns off, there is a very short peak of high voltage. Let's show a picture so you can see it better. And here you can see it on the picture with the short high voltage spikes. And this is probably the reason why it feels like more current than the multimeter shows. The multimeter shows 0.3 milliamps, but it feels like more current. Humans are probably more sensitive to those short spikes. Or the multimeter is less sensitive to it. So this is an electric shock brick game. And of course the oscilloscope was connected like this. Ground here, one channel here, and the other channel here. So this is my electric shock brick game, which demonstrates that humans are more sensitive to those short spikes of current compared to a sine wave current. At 0.3 milliamps of a sine wave current, you generally don't feel anything or just a very small tingle. But with those short peaks, it feels more because it actually is more current. 0.3 milliamps was the average current, but the peak current was much higher. So this is Diagon Wild, and see you in my next videos, and thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon, I really appreciate your support. And of course I plan another episode of my Spark Gap Tesla Coil series, and I also plan some series about a solid-state Tesla coil, or at least one video. And here I have some pipes, and you probably know the future purpose of those pipes, and I hope my cat is not going to try to go through the pipe and get stuck in it.